Okay, talk, do it. What you come up here, what you understand so far? Have you ever seen anything like this before? You never saw it like this before, right? You see these brothers standing out here? These are brothers, alright? Alright? These brothers have come to the knowledge of who they really are. Are we Negro? Are we Black? Are we African American? We out here to wake our people up and let them know who they really are.
Okay?
We have a history more than just coming over here on slave shit. Alright? So obviously something draws you over here. And I recognize that brother there. Yeah. You cut hair, right?
Oh yeah.
Now you cut your hair, you little brother. Alright, we ride motorcycles together too, right? So we got a little something in common, right? But really we got a whole lot in common.
Right.
We got a whole lot in common.
Right.
That's what we're getting ready to show you, brother. This is the real deal. Alright? Ain't nobody gonna show you this what we're gonna show you today.
Alright.
Okay? They ain't gonna teach you this in school. Your pastors in the churches ain't gonna teach you this, bro.
It's high time for you so-called Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans. It's high time you wake up to your true history.
We're the Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
We're the chosen people of God. Give me Deuteronomy 7 verse 6. I'm gonna show you something, bro. They ain't gonna tell you this. This is love out here. When you see brothers standing out here like this, these brothers come from all over North Carolina, alright? What's going on? Why are these brothers out here? God is dealing with them. God has dealt with them and continue to deal with them. God is waking his people up.
Right.
And it's high time for you to wake up too, bro.
That's right.
We've been bamboozled. We've been hoodwinked. We've been lied to. Alright? We're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. That's who we really are. So how can I say that if I don't have no proof to show you that? Well, this Bible here, okay, this is our history book.
Right.
When our people came over here and said, well, they're not allowed to read this. No, not at all. It's the reason for that. Because they want to take your mind and control it and put it in the mindset that they want you to be.
Right.
You promise that I'm going to sit. If you got any questions, bro, I promise you, we'll answer before you walk off of here, okay?
Yeah.
Me and you going to talk some more. We're going to get together. I got some stuff we got to talk about now. All right. Bring it out. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. But thou art the holy people. And God speaks to a people and said, thou art the holy people. Read on. Unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee. Or be chosen thee. It means somebody needs you. Alright? Well, you may say, well, that don't sound right. I don't want to be that type of God. That's what Christianity is told us.
That's right.
God chooses who he wants. But God said he has, read on. Thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people. Now you know good and well, the so-called Blacks, you know I say so-called, that's not who we really are.
That's right.
As an American, we are a special people. Everything we do is special, bro.
That's right.
Ain't nothing we can't do. Okay, let's bring it out, you know. A special people unto himself, above all people. No, below all people. Above all people. Why are we getting shot down in the streets, kid? Why am I getting shot down? Why Trayvon Martin getting shot down? What's going on? What happened to us as a people?
Bring it out!
You know, above all people that are upon the face of the earth. And that's coming out of a Bible. Preacher ain't never told me this. Reverend O'Donnell and T.D. Jakes ain't never told me this. I grew up in the church pretty much all my life. They never told me this. But see, you don't understand, bro. This Bible is your book. This Bible is our book. This is our history book.
That's right.
This is the most of, man.
Bring it up!
This is just a regular Bible. Come out of Walmart. So we ain't sitting up here asking nobody for no money.
Right.
We ain't asking nobody to join the organization.
Right.
No, bro, we out here in the hedges and highways. The Bible told you to do.
Right.
You don't been around them fake preachers. You know they ain't telling us nothing. Okay, well, we're going to bring it out. What you got?
Bring it out.
Look at the Leviticus. Chapter 20, verse 26. And ye shall be holy unto me. For I, the Lord, am holy. And have severed you. God has made us holy. What makes us holy is when we came out of Egypt, led by Moses. Moses is a Black man. The movies that they show us on TV, showing people being Caucasian or European, no, that's not who they really are. They were Black people. So-called Black people. They were the Israelites. That's who they really were. Okay? But God severed us and made us a holy people. What makes us holy is he separated. That's what made us develop all people. That's what made us special. He severed us, separated us, and gave us laws, statutes, commandments to govern us as a people. We would govern our own self. But when we didn't do what God told us to do, well, that's what happened to us. We went into slavery. That's how we get it up over here kicking pot.
That's right.
That's how me and you get it up over here. Okay? We're a product of what our forefathers done in the past. So we, the cycle has constantly been repeated over and over and over again, and we don't realize, okay? But we are something more than what we think. We do more than shoot a basketball. We do more than run a football 100 yards, break tackle. We do more than outrun everybody that there, step on the track field on. There's more to us than that, bro. And that's what our people don't know. That's what this whole society don't want you to know. Well, we can't hold a session like Presto Don TDJ or George Myers. Why is that? Because they don't want this truth to come out.
Right.
This ain't just going on right here in North Carolina, bro. That's going on in the national.
That's right.
Just waking up. Why? Because Christ, the black Messiah, is getting ready to come back and redeem his people.
That's right.
The sheep of the children of Israel. What you got? When we got conquered, brother, just like they would conquer any other nation,
they will take their history.
Right.
They will take their records.
Right.
And they will make their history and their records, they will make it their own.
Right.
That's why you see the movies that you do that is always about them. What about us? Where we come in at? Okay, we better than just getting beat on our back and coming out with your slave shit. That's what I'm saying, bro. There's something great about us way before we came over here.
That's right.
He has been right here all along. And he's gonna teach us, bro. Because he said, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. The knowledge of knowing who they are. The law, statutes, commandments that God gave us as a people.
Right.
That allowed us to rule this whole earth.
Right.
See, y'all don't talk about that. Y'all don't talk about that. What you got? The book of Psalms, chapter 147, verse 19. He showed his word unto Jacob. He showed his word unto Jacob. Abraham, we got Isaac. Isaac, we got Jacob. And Jacob had 12 sons. And those 12 sons, he showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes, that is judgments, unto Israel. Statutes and judgment unto who? Unto Israel. Unto Israel. Okay? That's who the statutes and judgment was given to. Unto us. To our forefather, his name became Israel. And we became those people. Okay? Well, she died. He have not dealt so with any nation. He have not done what? He have not dealt so with any nation. So he's dealing with, he's talking about nations here. He haven't dealt so with any nation. So this ain't no dang on religion, bro. This is who we are. We are a nation of people that's lost their identity. Where's the nation of black at? Where's the nation of Negro at? Where's the nation of African American at? Where's the nation? You ain't gonna find it. They think we're not no religion, bro. I want people to understand this has nothing to do with religion at all. It's who we are as a people.
Yes,
it's who we are as a people. Why not through history that our nationality constantly been changed from Negro to Black to Thug to Afro-American to African-American to European to Chinese. They ain't changed. But why ours keep changing? Somebody loves something like that. They don't really want you to know who you are, bro. I'm telling you. So let's get looking into the knowledge. What is that knowledge that my people parents will have?
That's a member book that y'all
see. Let's get understanding, because you know what? By my eye, this bro, preacher put two scriptures together, preach a message, moan, groan, sing, shout, and you ain't learned nothing. But this Bible will interpret itself. Okay? Watch this. Malachi chapter 2, verse 7. So what is the knowledge? Find out. Well, the priest lives to keep knowledge. But these pastors in the church, they live to keep knowledge.
We
and they should seek the law at his mouth. They should seek the word at his mouth. And they should seek the law at his mouth. These preachers, these pastors, they ain't teaching our people the law. But the priest's lips should keep knowledge, and they should seek the law at his mouth, for he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts. For he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts. Hold this picture up right here.
Bring it on!
This right here is a picture. We call that by Jesus. We know that's not the true image of Christ. You know that, right? The image of Christ, what the Bible says the image of Christ is. Is that the image of Christ right here? This is what they gave us when we came over here on the slave ship. This is the image that we've been betrayed and given all our life. Is this the true image of my brother and saint, the Christ?
Bring it out.
Brother said, hey, no. Is this the true image? But in the Bible, do you know what the Bible says about the true image of Christ? You got a little bit that you can tell. You got a little bit? He didn't have a little, except me. I said, the white people have a little hair. That's weak. Is that brother there? This cat here? I said, yeah, my brother, but is this cat here got a little hair? It's straight. That's right, straight. Exactly. Not only that, that's pretty bad. What you say, the hair, come on. You know a little bit of something. But we're gonna be looking over history to understand about this thing.
Bring it out!
I'm gonna tell you this. See, we study, we ain't no dumb niggas no more. Brothers study. Brothers got the spirit of God on them now.
That's right.
These people up. And it's time for these lies to be torn out. These dogs,
that's right.
These devils, it's time for them to be torn out. You see what I'm saying? Read on. Revelation, chapter 1, verse 14. Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ. The revelation. What do revelation mean? Revelation means to reveal, something. The revelation of Jesus Christ. Because most of you will say, it don't matter what Christ looked like. Well, if it didn't matter, why would it be written in a book? Okay? If it didn't matter, why would they change the image of the Bible says and give us that image? If it didn't matter. It does matter. It matters because they don't want you to know that Christ looked just like you. They don't want you to have no self-esteem. They don't want your son or your daughter, you blacks and Spanish names, they don't want you to feel like nothing. But you are something. I'm going to prove it to you. What you got? The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him, to show unto his servants. But if I'm going to show something to you, you got to have eyes to see it, don't you? To show unto his servants. I'm going to reveal something to you, John, okay? And I'm going to show it to you. And I want you to grip on. To show unto his servants things, which must shortly come to pass. And he sent and signified by his angel unto his servant God, who bear record. To bear record means to have to write it down, to keep record of. So in here we got the record. It's written right here. It's always been here. Okay? The record is to receive back the revelation and give it back. It's been written down. So we're going to find out what it says. We are. Who bear record of the word of God and of the testimony of Jesus Christ and of all things that he saw. All things that he saw. Give me one. Well, Jesus, let's watch this. We are. Revelation chapter 1 verse 14. But it don't matter. But you want to give me this image. Watch this. We are. His head and his hairs were white like wool. Strike one. You was right. His hair, was white like wool. There was no wool in there. Okay? This is the image that we portray. The Bible speaks of right here. Okay? We're not saying that this is Christ. But right there is the picture of what the Bible says right here, okay? It's just an image, alright? You know, his head and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were the flame of fire. His eyes were the flame of God. God's not the flame of fire. This ain't no sock talk or no X-Men type of thing, you know, pull the shades up. The first miracle that Christ does was turn water into wine. Am I right? They drunk wine. But watch this. It's the book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 12. So the Bible's going to explain itself. It said Genesis, going all the way back to the beginning. But the Christians don't, they don't go back to these books. They don't teach this back here. They New Testament the same, as they say. Okay? But that's real. You got to go back in order to understand.
Yes, sir.
To get the history on and understand what's going on in the future.
Right.
Now, his eyes shall be red with wine. There it is. His eyes shall be red with wine. This is a promise of Christ. Okay? Back in Genesis, Moses speaks of it right here. You see that? Read on. Don't forget. Back to Revelation. You see it? Revelation chapter 9, verse 14. His hair and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes at his feet, like a divine flame. What color is black? Okay? What color is black?
Bring it out!
What color? The black is a derivative of black. Okay? So, your feet, when your feet be the same color as your face and your arm, right? There's an image right there. Image is very important. That's why on TV they give you the image they want you to see. Even little kids, that image sticks into your mind.
That's right.
And when they see a picture like this, oh, that's on Jesus.
Right.
That's a lie.
That's right.
That ain't Jesus that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
See? Let's get into it. past is a rip to the ground. Okay? Read on. And it speaks like a divine brass, as if they burned in a furnace. So if you take brass, you take a piece of rice, you take anything, what you weigh, you throw it in the fire. What colors don't get? It's gonna get even dark, right? It's gonna become black. So Christ is a black man that the Bible speaks of. I'm gonna show you why we got this image here.
Bring it on!
Give me the first Maccabees 3:48.
Bring it on!
Relax a little bit. You know that ain't Christ. But just for the edifying of the people, that's what I'm gonna show you. Alright? First Maccabees, chapter 3 and verse 48. And laid open the book of the law. What is the book of the law? They laid open the book of the law. This is the book of the law right here, okay? The Bible is the book of the law. And this is the book of life, okay? Read on. And laid open the book of the law. Wherein the heathen, meaning other nations outside of these people here, the heathen, we ain't heathen. We ain't the Gentiles.
That's right.
The other nations, they can lie to us, make us think we were the heathen. Yes, we were called Gentile because we took on their ways.
Right.
Okay? Just like they call you an African American, but you're not African American. That's not who you are. Okay? You're Israelite, the Bible speaks of. But the heathen did what? Where is the heathen? And sought to paint the likeness of their images. The heathen, say that one more time. Where is the heathen?
Was delivered to the ceremonies of sacrifice. Christmas.
That's right. Easter. Right. We're doing it today. Don't realize we're serving the wrong God. We're serving the wrong true and Savior. The black Messiah is who we're going to be worshiping.
That's right.
We're never told to serve this man. He never gave us the Easter. He never gave us the Christmas.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? We're just ready right here. We've been serving this. So when you want to go down on your knees and pray, and in the church, you go to the church, thank the Lord. First image comes to people's minds is this image right here.
That's right.
They don't know this is the true image of God. They don't read.
Right.
The pastor said, we listen to the pastor too much. And I'm going to deal with him too. He's lying. They're lying. They're false prophets. That's why we are here. The prophets are deceit.
That's right.
Speaking to us smooth things.
That's right.
They stroke the people. Take the people money. Don't teach the people nothing.
Bring
they
stumble
back and sin. You see what I'm saying? That's how we lost as a people.
Bring it out.
But Christianity, that's what Christianity has done to our brother. So-called North again, which I'm saying, American in.
That's right.
The Puerto Ricans, the Cubans, you know what I'm saying? They don't assign to it. We got the history, bro. This is in the libraries. If you want to ask something, you need to go to it. What they say, they don't cliche, they say, no problem. If you want to ask something, you need to go to it. Put it in a book. Because they know we don't read.
That's right.
That's exactly right. Just look at the picture with no understanding. But let's read on. That they should make an image to the beast, which had the rule by its glory. Okay, he was wondering, one night he was getting it wrong. Okay, alright? Wrong is coming. Alright? But the beast, he said he didn't live. I mean, he came back, but he's still alive. America is your modern day wrong. America is your Babylon.
That's right,
America. That's who he's talking about today. Okay, we know. Verse 15. And he has power to give life unto the image of the beast. He has power to give life to the image of the beast. Why would he give life to the image of the beast? He gives life to the image of the beast through the media, through TV, through the movies that they put out. Sons of God, or what was it? Son of God, whatever. Exodus,
Passion of Christ.
Passion of Christ. We can even get all emotional and tears. We're all sensitive. That's what it does to us as men. Makes us inventive. Makes us soft. Weak men. Christ ain't soft. We're weak, bro. When Christ comes back, they're going to see something sure up close to that. Probably worse than that. I believe you. I'm telling you. What Christ going to do when he comes back? You think he'll come back singing with angels playing a harp and little dead babies and babies? No, bro. He's coming back to judge and make war. But that's how we wake you up, bro, so you can come out of it. You know? And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast. Let the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Just like I said, if they worship that image, you would be killed. They caused that image to speak. They caused it to speak through the media, through TV, through the movies. That's crazy, bro. But then again, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. Because we never knew this. We never been taught the Bible right. You see what I'm saying? But now, the true prophets of God are back.
Yes,
and let you know the true Messiah. Yes, he is black.
Yes,
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates from all our YouTube channels. Shalom.